found us running around with the wrong crowd. We'd be in for a lecture. If not more drastic measures. So it's difficult for us to identify with this passage of Scripture. Because we're good people, aren't we? Never run a yellow light, never blown past a stop sign.
And go back to our silo. Yes, sir.
thoughts, and that is our real attitude, then we all need to go back to the water.
You're right.
And we think that we've never made a mistake. Because he had a hundred sheep. You may not think that that's anything, but you've never dealt in livestock. This man had a lot of livestock. He wasn't a hireling. He wasn't watching somebody else's sheep. These were his.
I used to sit like a bump on a log.
you don't make noise, I'll make noise for you. If you don't wave your hands, I'll wave my hand for you. I'll sing for you. God is great and greatly to be praised. Do I have some help up in here? Somebody give God the praise. He said, because I found the one that was lost.
Yeah.
And I didn't find him dead, I found him alive. He was in danger. The sheep was in danger. I don't know if it was male or female. The sheep was in danger, but I found the
sheep.
And I brought the sheep back to the fold. I can imagine the sheep were shouting. The angels were shouting. His friends were shouting. He was shouting. The stars were shouting. The moon was dancing. The sun was shining. Hey, everybody was happy. There may be some people that you and I really can't reach. We're not their flavor. They don't identify with how we communicate. But this scripture gives us hope. Because it says that the angels rejoice because
God, I'm talking about.
into a single relationship.
Amen.
So now I'm answering somebody's question. Some of y'all want to know, why am I still here? I'm in my 80s, I'm in my 90s, whatever. Why am I still here? If you're still here, you still have work to do. You still have somebody that you're supposed to reach for Jesus. Somebody's lost. Somebody needs to be found. Somebody needs to be touched. Somebody needs to be encouraged. Somebody needs to be prayed for. Somebody needs hands laid on them. Come on, somebody.
But it's really not that complicated. We just need to let folks know what you've done for us.
Yes, sir.
And how you've been with us every step of the way. How you forgave us when we went the wrong way. How you brought us back from sin and shame. All we have to do is just recommend you to them. And ask them to give you a chance. If anyone lets you in today, you'll come in to stay. We pray that this word has touched somebody. Somebody will consider you. And for those of us who are stuffy and stiff, help us to loosen up. So that we can reach the masses. People of every birth. Do it for your glory. We thank you, God, for this opportunity. Somebody needs you, Lord. Somebody is hurting. Somebody's crying. There's still families grieving over those who were lost on 9/11/2001. Comfort them. Give them peace that surpasses human understanding. Take the blood thirst, the taste of blood out of the mouths of humankind. Help us to forgive. Help us to repair. I pray, God, that you will give even now the royal family in England some sense of peace. But help them understand that this is a new opportunity for them to make right for the centuries of colonialism and oppression. When Queen Elizabeth II closed her eyes, it is estimated that she was worth $26 billion. We know that artifacts and jewels and other resources were basically taken from other countries to enrich the United Kingdom. God, there needs to be a reckoning and an awareness of that. Then there needs to be the repair. We pray, God, that you will continue to trumpet justice throughout the earth. We love you and we praise you. We thank you and we bless you. Someone wants to come to Christ in this house. The door of the church is open. If on Facebook, go to our Facebook page. Follow the prompts. You can make your profession of faith, and we'll be happy to sign you up for the Praise God.
Praise God.
Thank God. Put your hands together and give God a glory. Let us stand. I was so blessed yesterday as I was finishing up my playlist. I came across one of my childhood idols. She did ministry in Oakland, California at the St. John Missionary Baptist Church. She was arguably their lead soloist, Elizabeth Crosby, who later married and became Elizabeth Ayala. Time has been good to her. God has been good to her. She has produced a wonderful album. And one of the selections is Seeking for Me. Now, if you go on YouTube, it is mislabeled. And that's all right, because I was determined to find this song. And with the help of Brother Karam, we have it this morning. Amen. And I want you to listen to it. The song on YouTube is labeled In the Blood, but it is really the rendition Seeking for Me. Listen and be blessed.
Jesus, my Savior,
similarity. And that's the kind of spiritual food I grew up on. That's why I am fat and rich in Jesus. Yes. Somebody put their hands together and pray. So glad about it. So glad about it. Listen, we thank and praise God for this time together. Thank God for all of you who have shown up this morning on this cloudy but sultry late summer Sunday morning. We thank and praise God for this space and place called Calvary. We thank God that since we entered this sanctuary on the 10th of April, 1977, the doors of the church have remained open. Anybody glad about that? And 56 years prior to that, we were at 1330 Joseph Campo. Anybody glad about that? And for 2 years, from 1919 to 1921, we were at 1440 St. Antoine. God has brought us 103 years. Sometimes up, sometimes down, sometimes level to the ground, but God has brought us, and we ought to be grateful. And at a time when we should have gone under, God rescued us. I'm not embarrassed to say that. I'm going to say more about it in the ensuing weeks. But God stepped in and provided an intervention for us because we could not save ourselves. Amen. We put forth some valiant efforts, but we couldn't save ourselves. But somebody in here believed God would save us.
Yes, Lord.
Am I in here by myself? Somebody believed that God would save us and give us a future. And we thank and praise God.
Yes, Lord.
So we thank God for the second Sunday of Founders Month. We will thank God for the 18th of September when we get to it. And then on the 25th, we're going to be like this man who found that lost sheep. We're going to holler. We're going to celebrate. We're going to party in Jesus' name. Anybody gonna dance with me? Yeah, we want to invite everybody to come and dance with us. So we celebrate 103 years and burn the mortgage. Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. And when you come to a party, you don't come empty-handed, do you?
That's right.
You're supposed to bring a gift, aren't you? $1 for every year the church has been alive is not an insignificant gift. For some, it will be a sacrificial gift. Others will be able to do substantially more. I'm just asking you to have a talk with God. Don't talk to yourself, talk with God. And after you have a talk with God, then do your best. And I'm a living witness that if you do your best, God will do the rest. And this is in addition. This is not in substitution. This is in addition to our regular giving. So we invite our Facebook congregation to join us. Yeah, you can use Cash App. You you can use, give them a mind. Send us a love gift. Help us move forward in Jesus' name and do ministry, meaningful ministry, in Jesus' name. Those who are in the sanctuary, you will deposit your love gifts as we leave the sanctuary. Amen. Praise God and thank God. I thank God for the committee that is working so diligently behind the scenes to make our Founders Day and mortgage burning celebration everything that it ought to be, in Jesus' name. We thank God. Our offertory selection at this particular point is a rendition from a brother that I have called on ever since we have, well, ever since 2020, I'll just leave it like that. But I stumbled across Brother Marvin Williams, and he's all right with me. And he doesn't need a band, he doesn't need an orchestra, he doesn't need a choir. God has anointed his voice, and he sits in front of a piano, and sometimes he sings a cappella, but this particular rendition, he does use the piano. It's short and sweet. The Lord is blessing me right now. Listen and be blessed.
Continue to bless each and every one of us those that may not have had, and those that have and have given, we ask that you bless us all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
send us from this place. Never from your this. Send us from this place, but never from your presence. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.